Actually, what happened is that in the early 1800s, gaucho was the represented in Argentina, the American cowboy. He was a man where his best friend was a horse and the circle was his wife. he loved to spend evenings with a guitar and sing songs, improvise, and was called Pachero. Pachero is the person that makes words at the moment. He improvises the words and the music at the same time. And they had it was an art on how to write and improvise poems of love, or talking about the fields or the horses or the day that they were going through, and the animals and the cows and the bulls. In the early 1800s, what happened is that the Spanish colony started taking the land away from the gauchos. And the gaucho became rebellious and resentful, mad, angry. So, Madrida, that was not interesting, you know, where the gaucho becomes resentful and upset and mean because of what was happening to them. And they were being pushed to the south or to the west and the different lands, you know, away from the city of Buenos Aires. But the gaucho matrero also implies the dance of the gaucho. And the dance is called malambo. Actually, my email address is e malambo, e for a bird or malambo, the dance. And he wrote in 1940 a single piece called Malambo, which is recorded by me. And it's a short piece, but very effective because it has an incredible rhythm. But the important thing about the music rhythm here is that Ginastera wrote a lot of music in 6/8. And the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is always divided, giving stress to the 1 and to the 4. And despite that sometimes certain chords or certain accents fall in the 5th, 8th note or in the 6th, 8th note, always the left hand has the main chords and never stops. So it's very important that the left hand maintains that pause, and when the right hand is in syncopation, you have to reinforce more the left hand. Okay? The passage is like. Detached or non-legato attached. So I would recommend to you that you all the sections like this. But you know, to have that evenness in the sound and in the pulse, that has to be almost insisting in order to begin. Because it's, like I said, the gaucho dance, you know? The gaucho dance goes like this.
Thank you.
recommend that you think a great deal in the hand position, because that is what is going to give you the clarity, articulation, and convincing sound. Okay? Yeah. Don't be afraid of it. This is bellissimo, but you know, you have to project. I always say that pianissimo or piano is not in the air, because then it doesn't go anywhere. You know, it doesn't project. And then the sound has not conviction. So despite the pianissimo, thing in the right hand, you have to show me the first with the right, with the left, I mean. Sometimes the students are too young to play certain repertoire. Alicia de la Rocha wanted to play August Spanish music, and her teacher made her practice until she was 15 all the Mozart sonatas and all Bach, so her hand will be firm and secure in a closed position. The closed position means that the hand stays, you know, like if I do. Thank you. So if you're driving in this position, or a small ball, anything.
Okay. some places it's the evenness of the notes, because even though it's step scene, you can kind of slur them together. You don't want to be missing notes or too much.
Okay. And what else?
It can be hard at times to not mess up the rhythm.
And according with more bite or less bite, motion of the finger is what brings the it's like a ball. The ball bounces, you push the ball down, and the ball bounces up. So the motion is that the fingers do this action, and then in the moment that we drop the sound with the visibility of the wrist and the hand weight, the fingers receive the weight, but the action of my fingers doing this is what produces the bounce, yeah? Which I use a great deal in many things.
Thank you.
Okay. So it's amazing how much we can do with the fingers, you know? Also with the fingertips. As we go stronger, then we go stronger. And the sound, the caressing is so important because it's also applied. Nuances, colors, atmospheres. Okay. And this, when you practice this, thinking what the piano can offer you, and search for the sound. And because of the piano like this, I got one sound. If I go like this, I got a different sound. Okay? If I go like this, if I do going to react with an accent. It's true. It's true. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
I was telling her before, in about the rhythm, the thing always in the 1-2-4-6 or 1-2-4-5, I'm more detached in certain passages, and more clarity between what is, you know, the first theme, which is the beginning, is what I call, is my own feeling, is the male character, you know? And then when the second theme comes, is the female. Which doesn't mean that the female is weaker and the male is, sometimes female are stronger than men, you know? But in general, you know, what I'm trying to say is that the second theme has more the femininity, in the sense of sensuality and tenderness and love. So when I think this is part of
thank you.
because it's a group of two.
Running.
So, but very dry.
Thank you.
And 5.1 are the buttons for the clock. Also have the world. I think a very strong blacks and reds, and you know, the colors and the paintings of the Pollock, that there is a famous painted with the brush and throwing paint to the canvas and having all these splashes of strong colors. Think about that, because this is beautiful music, but it had to be played with not only with brightness, but also with colors and noise, you know? This movement is beautiful. I'm planning to do the recital with work is works. It's a long cycle, but it can be done if the energy and stamina is there. And I would like to do the recital, and I would like to do organize some kind of a theater festival where students will perform in a theater kind of music. And also, there is only one survivor in Hitler's family because his two wives died, and his son also died quite young, and he has only one daughter, Georgina. The Rondo and Children's Songs, the Rondo is a beautiful piece. So from that time on, I went to stay in New York, and then he was based in New York where he was doing the opera of Marcel, and then later he did the teacher Chinchi and Don Rodrigo, and they were all performing in the Washington Opera House. And so I did play other music that I had been studying, and then I met him again in Buenos Aires, and I played more music, and I had a good relation with him. And in 1983, I invite him, in 1982, I invite him to come to USC to give a lecture, and I was going to demonstrate. And I talked to him like in August, September, and then in December I called again, and his wife said, "Oh, Alberto is not feeling well, and we don't know what's wrong, and he died 6 months later." So he never made it to the States. And of course, the music world was very sad. He's still a young man, and producing so much wonderful music. So, what I want to say is that Georgina Ginastera wrote a book with all the letters of his father. And she had been doing lectures and talking about his relationship with the father and experience, their experience when he was traveling and gone, and talking about his music. And she wants to do with me something connected with talking herself and me playing music. And maybe something that we've done here too. I want to definitely do it. In some other places and back in the other workshop. I think it's 16. 16. Yeah. If I'm still alive. and if I have the fingers and the head. Okay. Okay. Let's dance now. La Paz by Ravel. You're wearing like this, so I give you one. Give me your one. This is an amazing. amazing piece of music, and I have great admiration for her because it's actually very demanding and a very difficult piece. Have you listened to some versions? What do you think you listen to? Do you like her performance?
Yeah.
You know, I heard her in person playing the bass, I think a year ago, she played in listening.
Oh.
And I was telling the professor here that she made me cry with the bass.
Wow.
It was so, so incredible. What she created was absolutely amazing. It was the best thing in the entire program. But you know, I hear there is an incredible version that is even better than me. He's a pianist from Lisboa, from Portugal. His name is Arthur Pistarro. And he added to the version more stuff, and he dedicated this version to Martha Anchorage. And his playing is mind-blowing. I recommend that all of you hear him. Arthur Pizarro. Fantastic. This is probably the best ever performance I ever heard. And he's in Kansas. I think he's teaching there, right? Okay. You want to see?
Thank you.
have a good feeling for it, which is the most important thing, you know? And you have a flair with the music and the voice quality, and you dance with it. This is wonderful. One thing I want to ask you. I want to do this with you. Feel that you are completely relaxed in the shoulders. And do this.
Yeah.
16, but more to do. In the Tchaikovsky, I always feel that the sound has to connect from one chord to the next. I'm always doing a circular motion. So from here, Help yourself. very good. Now, when you start finishing,
thank you.
allow the sound note.
so you kept it and one.
We listen to the ringing quality. And always about beautiful sound, you know. It's I was very lucky because when I was 11 years old, my teacher made me be so aware of sound and never push, never force, never, and have always be sensitive to the piano and to the sound.
Thank you so much for a wonderful applause. Please come.